Hello students, in this part we are going to talk about the unit and measurement. Question come, why this is very important to study this chapter, unit and measurement, as the name given, unit and its measurement. Here you can see that is the time which is shown by the clock, length and mass, right? So three basic fundamental quantities which is come into picture. If I will ask you nowadays, if you are wearing a fitting clothes just because of accurate measurement, if measurement is not there, you cannot do that. Now the question come, what is this measurement and why we are doing all such measurements? So what is the need of measurement? Measurement is very important in our day-to-day life as it gives an accurate precision. If the accurate precision of something is not there, we cannot measure anything. In olden days, the people used to measure the distances, like some are measuring by throwing a stone, some are measuring the distances by walking. They are calculating the distance and that they are measuring, and that they called as a distance, right? And they are measuring the distances like this. They are telling the time by seeing the position of the sun or by keeping the sand in the box, and that is they are placing it inverted, and that way they are calculating the things, but precision is not there. So now we are going to talk about the physical quantities. What is physical quantity means? A physical quantity which can be measured directly or indirectly is called physical quantities, right? The physical quantities are of two types, base quantities and derived quantities. Now, what is this base quantity, if I will ask you? That is the fundamental quantities. Like just now I told you, basically there are three fundamental quantities which we are taking into a picture. That is your mass, length and time. But still there are seven fundamental or base quantities we have. And along with that, we have seen the derived quantities. What are derived quantities? Derived quantities are those quantities which can be derived with the help of the fundamental physical quantities. There are 100 in numbers, right? Now if you will see here in the current picture, the physical quantities. Here physical quantities, you can see I have the meter, that is simply a length, time, mass, current, temperature, mole of substance, or we can say intensity of light, right? And these are the quantities which you can see here which have derived with the help of the physical or the fundamental quantities, right? Now if I will ask you that why, what is the need of all these discussion and why we are discussing all these in detail, so before we will go into the details of this derived units and physical fundamental units and all these things, first we will understand that what is the process of measurement. The measuring process, as we have already seen, what is physical quantity, derived quantities. Now measurement, if we talk about, okay, the standard should be some convenient, defined and easily reproducible quantity of same kind in terms of which the physical quantity as whole is expressed. This standard is called a unit. What the unit means? We need some standard of a physical quantity of the same kind in which we can measure the given amount or given substance, right? For the measurement of the physical quantity, two things are very important. One, the unit in which the physical quantity is expressed, and the second, the number of times of the given unit. So here the formula for measuring its physical quantity, here Q, its physical quantity is equals to N number of times into U. Here you can see, for example, I have written 5 meter. You can see that meter, we already know, it gives the sense of length. So here N is showing what? That is a numerical value, okay? And U is showing the unit of measurement. Now if I will see this, if I will convert this meter into centimeter, so it will turns to 500 centimeter. So from here clearly we have understood that what it is, that is if the unit is small, so the measurement magnitude will be more. But if the unit is big, the measurement magnitude will be less. So we can say here that N is inversely proportional to 1 upon U, which is, or we can say NU is equals to constant. What does it mean? It means that the smaller size of the unit, the larger is the numerical value associated with the physical quantity. Here you can see this is 5 meter of length. Okay, and here you can see this is 500 centimeter. Centimeter is a smaller unit, but the numerical value of this is
max means the more value is there, right? So if the this is a small, the unit will be big. If the unit will be big, this will be large. So this we have seen, or this we have understood from this. Okay.
Now we have seen that how we can measure and what is the process of measurement. So what are the basic need? First thing is mass. Okay. What is mass? Mass of a body is defined as a quantity of matter contained in the body. Means if any body we have, if I will say this is the duster, what is the mass, what is the weight of this body that we can consider? Okay, so what is this mass we have discussed? So characteristics of mass, if we will talk about, so mass of a body is directly proportional to the quantity of matter contained in it. Means how much the body is containing, that a body containing a mass, that matter is containing in that, that is defined as its mass. Okay, the mass of a body is independent of the size and the shape. It doesn't matter that what size and what is the shape of that mass is, it's independent of size, right? Mass does not change by the presence of any other body near to it. What does it mean? If suppose this, the mass of this duster, whatever it is, if I'm going to keep a marker pen over here, it does not change any change will not come in the mass of the duster, right? And the mass of a body cannot be zero. It can't be zero. Okay. If we talk about mass, so mass is of two types. One is your inertial mass and the another one is called your gravitational mass. Inertial mass and the another one is gravitational mass. What is inertial mass if we talk about? So inertial mass is the mass of a body, is a quantitative measure of the inertia body. It's a quantitative measure, means something is which is kept or what is present on this earth, that we are going to consider, we are going to take, we are going to study about it, that is inertial mass. What is gravitational mass? It is the property on which the gravitational force of attraction of the earth, of the body depends. Practically, if we talk about, these two masses are same. We are considering there is no difference in the inertial mass and the gravitational mass. Both mass are equal. Okay, so that's why we are only considering, we are talking about only mass. So this is what we have talked about, the concept of mass. The unit of mass is what? The unit of mass is kg. Kilogram is the unit of mass, right? So this is the unit of mass which we called kilogram. Okay. Now next we are going to talk about the concept of length. Okay. See, why we are talking about mass and length and time. If we talk about these three terms are very basic. Okay. If I will talk to you, or if I will ask you, whatever we are taking or whatever we are holding in our hand, we can come to know it by its mass. What is the weight of that, right? Now length we will talk about. The extent of separation or a distance between two points in the space is called length. Here I have draw a one diagram. This is the length. When I am going to measure at this two points of this rod is separated by some distance. That distance when we are going to measure, that gives the extent of, that gives a length of this particular. And this is defined as length. If we talk about in 1971, okay? In 1791, French Academy of Science, okay, what they have defined? They have defined 1 meter is equal to the 1/10 million of the distance from the North Pole to the South Pole of the equator. They have calculated the distance from the North Pole to the South Pole, that is the 1/10 million. Okay, who has done this? This they have done by the French Academy. Later on, the same definition is redefined by in 1899. This definition of length is defined in 1899. It was redefined the distance between the two lines marked on
platinum and iridium. They have took a one rod of platinum and iridium, and they have kept this in our laboratory, and there they have kept this rod at the temperature or constant temperature of 273 Kelvin at 1 bar pressure, and that length which they have obtained by this, they have called that rod as 1 meter. Okay, then later on, International Bureau, when SI unit we are going to discuss, we will talk about this particular. So this is the history of your length, how the length unit has come into picture. So the unit of length is what? That is meter. Okay, the unit of length is meter. Okay, concept of time, if we will talk about, so that according to Albert Einstein, what he said, what simply a clock reads is called time. Okay, what a simply clock gives an idea, that is time, right? But if we talk about that, is time is also a measure of a duration between the occurrence of any two event. Okay, if any two event occurs in between, the duration of this is also gives an the time. Okay, the sense of time, or we can say it's also when the last event had occurred, that is also gives us a concept of time. There are several phenomena in a nature which repeat itself in a regular interval of time, right? Or we can say in a definite duration, like rotation of earth, right? Rotation of earth about its axis, right? And revolution of the earth around the sun, right? And that causes the change in the season. So, and the oscillation of the pendulum and the heartbeat, all these things if we will talk about, so these things are repeating themselves in a regular period of time, right? In a regular interval, I can say. So time is not only which clock shows, but the time is also something which is repeating or repeat itself after regular interval of time, that can be said to be a measure of time. The unit of time is second. The unit of time is second. Second is the unit which we are using for measuring the time. So in the beginning of the unit, the time was defined, or it was defined as follows. First is mean solar second. Okay, one mean solar second is equal to 1 upon 24 into 60 into 60, that is gives a mean solar second, or that is a mean solar day, right? And that is what we have seen in the beginning, we have considered. So basically the concept of time is this. Now the question comes, why we have only talked about mass, length and time? Because these are the very basic, or we can say a very basic units, right? Mass, if I will ask you, that is very relatable from the beginning. If we can talk about Stone Age, from the Stone Age, if I will say the two stones are there, okay? If two stones are kept, which one is bigger? From the size you can tell. But I will ask you, which one is heavier, or which one is more, having a more weight? You need to know its mass. Length. If I want to measure something, I need a length. Time. And what is the importance of the measurement, you understood? Now, what is the importance of unit? Suppose I will say, you will ask me my weight, I will say 56. If I will say height, if you will ask length, if you will ask of this board, I will say 10. Time, if you will ask, I will say 5. These numbers, this magnitude doesn't make any sense. It will start making sense when I will use this kg, I will use this meter, and I will use this as 6. 5 a.m. or something like that. So that's why the concept of time and all these things are very important.